flag goes down. BriSCA 4-2 soccer, he number one, the white and yellow final is away and races. 9-2-9, who leads away? That's Harry Hensby, local rider here at King's Lynn. He's looking well at this one at the minute. Trying to look at the inside is Richard Lindsay in kind of a 3-7-5. But Hensby is who leads. Oh dear, some problems out there. 5-8-2 in trouble. One of the yellow tops absolutely flying from the yellow grey. It's Kyle Taylor in kind of 1-3-6 who won the dash for the cash here. Has been absolutely flying here at King's Lynn. 7-1-7. Michael Clark on the middle after being involved in that early problem with 5-8-2 tops of straight. Here comes the lead car though. It's 9-2-9. Harry Hensby leads away. Richard Lindsay is second. That's Carl Taylor now through to second, and already even at this stage Taylor looking like a good odds bet for victory here. He was absolutely flying in the dash for the cash here. The last time the Formula 2's race went home with a wheelbarrow full of money, and it looks like he could well turn the big race here. So that green flag goes out, we're away and racing. Formula 1 stock car, Grand National Championship, it's Whelan Jr. who gets the break on Tom Harris in Cannavore. Tom Harris is going to go around bumper straight away in the goal, and Harris there gets put straight up the fence, and it's Whelan who leads it. 5-1-5, Harris in trouble in Cannavore, he gets thrown out. Ferris goes in, he goes Griffin. Oh, and they're all the way down there in this hard hitting Grand National Championship. Paul Hines in trouble, and Joe Nichols, they both spin out in Cannavore 2-4-9. And 2-4-2, but it's Whelan Jr. who leads in kind of a 5-1-5. Bobby Griffin second in kind of 1-6-6, then it's Furs in 2-1-7. Matt Newson in 16. Ryan Harrison's coming through now in kind of a 1-9-7. He's flying, he's Ryan in 1-9-7. He's gone past Tom Harris in kind of a 1. Harris struggling a bit with the pace of Harris, but he tries to come back on the inside in down the back straight. Whelan Jr., the race leader, in kind of a 5-1-5. Second place is Bobby Griffin in a caliber 166. Dennis Lee for Harrison 217 and 197 Ryan Harrison. Whelan Jr., the race leader, he flies down on the back straight leading this one. Bobby Griffin in that second spot, Lee Ferguson. Ryan Harrison's coming through now in caliber 197. He's been shadowed. Oh, Bobby Griffin in trouble in caliber 166. He's gone as Griffin, and he's gone, gone Griffin. Or gone, gone Griffin, I guess, in the 166 car. Whelan Jr., almost half a lap in front in caliber 515. Oh, and in goes Ryan Harrison there on Tom Harris. I didn't even see Tom go past right there, but Ryan's not messing about. The boss is looking to put the bumper in. And in he goes again on Tom Harris. The bump goes through there. Oh, my word, fascinating racing for those two. Whelan Jr., though, he's enjoying this. He's way out in front in caliber 515. Ferris has a good break in second, and it's Ryan Harrison through to third from Tom Harris. Takes in line as Matt Newsom picks up a puncher in caliber 16. Oh, Griffin's got to the infield. Lee Ferris in trouble. The top, second, third, and fourth are all together. Ryan Harrison's going to try and pull Ferris wide. He goes up once again. It's fantastic racing here from these top three, and he's halfway next time. Mr. Starter, halfway next time for 5-4-5. Frankie Whelan Jr. So then, it's Harrison now into second place in caliber 197 from Tom Farris. In comes Finnegan, he's come from nowhere in caliber 55. Oh, and Farris goes, tangles with Finnegan, that's cost both of those time. Old front is still Junior Weber who leads in caliber 515. Ryan Harrison now second. So then, yellow test on this one. To all intents and purposes, done and dusted, really. It's halfway next time, it's now halfway next time. 372 Goodwin second, 150 Mick Sora coming to third place now. So then Tesla flying on through. The caliber 4 take, Goodwin second in 372. Sora third in that 1-5. Green flag goes out, we're away and racing, and it's Jack Wicks who gets the break. Is he going to get down into turn one ahead? Yes, he is, 27. Can he do anything about it? In second spot, Stuart Barzi, he tries on the go, but no, Wicks has managed to escape that completely. And, well, this could all be up and down, to be honest. Wicks is already pulling away from the rest of the field. It's going to take something really special to reel him in. 27. Lucas Stuart Barzi trying to do just that. Jack Wicks, the race leader, from the 27 car, bumpers go flying in the barrel for third place. But Wicks it is now extending his lead at the head of affairs. Can number 27, Luke Sirabarsby, in a second spot, but we're certainly getting further ahead. Grace Esquire up to third in the car number 29. So Jack's certainly got his wits about him, says Mr. Stewart, always among the classic one-liners. And Reds, Mr. Starter, and Reds, Mr. Starter, Reds. And a rollover down there, we missed that one completely. Out of that sort of hassle. Oh, and is it spun there? And he's still Lindsay, keeps on making the old mistake, but he's driving a good enough front, leading the way still. But how much longer can he keep this horde of former two slot cars behind him? Well, Greg McKenzie now right on his back bumper in car number 47, and it's 47 McKenzie who and it's halfway next time, it's not halfway next time. Greg McKenzie puts the bumper in on Lindsay, and it's Greg McKenzie who hits the front in car number 47. Greg McKenzie driving really, really well. Oh, Buckley there is spun out. He's just avoided by David Polley, who is the red top making the most progress at the moment. And he's certainly flying on through this field, is Polley. So as we reach halfway stage, it's 47 McKenzie who leads. In second place, it's still Richard Lindsay. In count of 375, then Jordan Fokker. In count of 324. And David Polley and Dave Brennan. In count numbers 38 and 968, respectively. So then, Greg McKenzie leading down the back straight. Jordan Thacker looks like he's moved through to second place. The move is shadowed by Dave Polley, who again is shadowed by Dave, by not Dave Brennan, Mickey Brennan, in count of the 968. So then, 47, McKenzie White, Greg McKenzie, the race leader. Second place, Polley now has gone through to second. Oh, we're trying to have a go with him there. He's, oh, and look at that. Out goes 183 Ginchard. But up front, it is still 47 who leads, but the chase is now on from Polley. In count number 47, down the back straight, bombs out there for Mr. Star Richie Bowyer. In count number 761. There are 5 laps to go next time, Mr. Starter. 5 laps next time around for Greg McKenzie. In count number 47, our race leader. Dave Polley still some way off in count number 38. And in third place is Mickey Brennan in car number 968. Greg McKenzie still the race leader in car number 47. Driving very well going down the back straight. Dave Polley is making some form of inroads, but will it be enough and will it be in time? Because the lap board's around, the laps are counting down. It's the blue top who leads. It'd be fantastic if he could hang on. Not been racing for two stock cars too long, but good, a couple of years experience now, and he's driving exceptionally well in tonight's Grand Final, leading the way. 47, Greg McKenzie, the race leader. Dave Polley still second in car number 38. And in third place is still Mickey Brennan in car number 968. So then Greg McKenzie, a few back markers behind him. They are under racing with this... Stockard Grand Final. Oh, Thornton's over there straight away between the Reds and the Blues. And Finnegan tries to go around the outside of half the field, and it looks like it could well come off. Oh, red! Reds, Mr. Starter, Reds on the raceway. And plenty of action straight away on the opening lap. We told you it would be action packed, and goodness me, it all certainly happened in the early laps in this one.